All right. So the spiritual aspect of these kinds of events and worldly situations is they actually do act as a test. They test your ability to live your spirituality, and your spirituality is reflected in your ability to use your intelligence when it makes it very obvious and in this moment difference. It's one thing to have a modicum of intelligence and a degree of wisdom, but can you bring it to bear? Can you use it when the monkeys are rattling the cages so that you don't start feeling crazy? So this is always to be seen as whatever else it is. It's a kind of a small spiritual test. I don't look at it as a big deal. But if you want to live the spiritual life and you see yourself as a spiritual seeker who is definitely on the spiritual path, and if you're listening to me, that's the category you're in, then this becomes, times like this and events like this become a mini test of your resilience and ability to put that into play, ability to actually demonstrate that your spiritual life strengthens you and makes you able to bear things more easily, more gracefully, that are quite difficult for conventional or highly conditioned, enculturated people. It doesn't make you better. It means you're in a better position. But if you don't know how to actualize it, how to bring it into daily life, then it doesn't do you much good. Then it's a idea you have about yourself that doesn't change or affect how you carry yourself. This is the nature of the test. Can you bring it out in your daily life so that you're steadier, so that you're less affected by nonsense, so that you're not overly frightened by the loud noises you'll hear around you, so that you're not giving credence to the nonsense talk that will increasingly be the nature of the things people say and what you hear when you turn on your interweb set. So it's not a big deal, but you should be aware of the spiritual test aspect, because people do tend to think it is a common unconscious and even conscious notion. In the New Age mindset, it's conscious. And people who are more serious, it tends to be more unconscious. But there is this idea that spirituality is something in you rather than it has no specific place or time or form. So to bring it into daily life is kind of where the rubber meets the road. If you can't bring it into daily life, then it's just a feeling or an idea, and it doesn't have much to offer you in the way of usefulness and transformational power. If you can't consciously bring it to the table when it's most needed, when it's most helpful, when it actually supports you and gives you much more balance, then you can't claim that your spiritual focus is as real as you hope it would be, because the test of the realness of it is that you can bring it to bear, that you can bring it into daily life, that you can actually manifest it in how you deal with what you deal with and how you act, speak, think, and do. if it isn't influencing that in a way that you're consciously aware of, then it's not. And you can't claim that you are the beneficiary of the spiritual path. It's like pretending you have muscles without going to the gym or doing any exercise, pretending your muscles have strengthened and gotten bigger when you've just been imagining that you should go to the gym, but you haven't actually gone. So this is the test. Here's the 150-pound weight. The test is, can you lift it or not? So it's a small test, but if you look at it that way, you can see that it does have meaning. And if you can't pass the small tests, you have no chance for the big tests. And this is another common notion. I speak about it quite often, that people have the idea that the small tests don't matter, the small demonstrations don't matter, the day-to-day doesn't matter, because when the big moments come, they'll rise to the occasion. We've all done this. We tell ourselves, I'll rise to the occasion, I'll kind of pull myself up by my bootstraps, and I'll do it right, or I'll respond the right way, or my spirituality will save the day. But we are guaranteed that that won't happen. We are guaranteed to fail the big tests if we are routinely ignoring or failing the small tests. How you pass the big test, how you demonstrate being able to stand up with the support of the your own spirituality, your own spiritual feeling and your own spiritual wisdom, how you pass the big moments successfully, where that comes into play, is by bringing it into play purposely, consciously, intentionally, in the small moments, in the small tests. So the small tests are the preparation for the big tests. If you skip them, if you decide this is too small to bother with, you are guaranteeing yourself future failure. So the smart way is to strengthen yourself and pass the small tests, and that makes you confident about the medium-sized tests, which then makes you fairly optimistic about your statistical chances for when the big tests come. And the big tests will always come sooner or later. They're not often. There's only a few in life. And the last one, how you die, is guaranteed for all of us. So if you think the tests are coming, then you've forgotten about death.